So RA&TA opportunities depend on your TOEFL score. At least that is what our old program director, she left, assistant director. That was she told me. She told me that for TA and RA, one thing that you need is basically communication skill. So you're going to talk to, so when TA is basically you teach some subject, RA is basically you're going to assist the professor in doing some research or, you know. So RA opportunities are basically based on what your, the, like if you reach out to, you can reach out to some professor and he'll take your interview, and then if he likes you, you will get an RA. TA is more of a teaching, so you're going to teach undergrads. So for that, your communication skills have to be strong. So they are going to look at your TOEFL score, which should be above 110 overall, and your speaking should be above like 27 or something. I don't remember exactly. Around $15 an hour, that was when I was a student. There are, because our campus is small, there are not many on-campus jobs available, and you have to start looking for them before you even, you know, reach US. And most of the on-campus jobs go to the engineering students because their network is really strong and there are a lot of engineering students as compared to business students. So most of the jobs are occupied by them. On-campus jobs don't pay you much. It's around 10 to 12, 12 to 13 dollars per an hour, but it's like more than enough to, like, you know, pass your entire month if you get it. So I-20 was $44,000, and that is usually the maximum amount of money that you'll actually spend in your first year. But it's, what we actually ended up spending was much less than that. So I-20 typically includes your estimated living expenses and everything. But if you, like, depending on where you choose, your living estimate could be a lot cheaper, and you can save up on, save up there. And so I ended up spending around $40,000 in my first year, and I don't have, and you're in your second year, you're already earning because you're doing your co-op. Yeah. So you can cover your, whatever your 5 or 6 credits are left, you can cover those expenses by your internship, by what you make in your internship. So when they give out initial scholarships, they usually give out to 5 or 6 people. So that includes like a couple of $2,000 scholarships, a couple of $5,000 scholarships, and one $10,000 scholarship. That was the case in my year. So initial expenses are going to be your deposit, your rent of your first month, and the things that you typically buy from us. So that'll be your things like your probably your microwave or your study table or your iron and, like, you know, your chair and, like, furniture you buy. Your mattress will be expensive. Okay. And obviously the, like, if you decide to buy a professional attire from there, then good. If you decide to buy it from here, it's going to be expensive.